I now hand the conference over to Mr. Alex Vergis, CFO of Shankara Building Products Limited. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thank you. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm welcome to all of you. I hope all of you are doing well. Today, I'm joined by Mr. Sukumar Srinivas, Managing Director, Mr. C. Ravikumar, Executive Director, and Strategic Growth Advisor, our Investor Relations Advisors in this conference call. We have uploaded our results and a presentation on the exchanges, and I hope everybody has had an opportunity to go through the same. With that, I will begin my brief explanation on the result. Quarter 3 saw a further improvement in sales on a sequential basis. We are at about 80% of sales on a comparison with FY20. We are on target for the current financial year. There is a pickup seen in demand across all our segments, which was muted in quarter 2, has also shown signs of revival on the back of pickup and automobile industry and general engineering. Our channel sales saw consistent demand. There was considerable increase in the price of steel and commodities in general. In the retail side, we are seeing a pickup in walk-ins. We are seeing an average of around 10 walk-ins per day per counter. This is almost nearing normalcy. We had seen barely 4 to 5 walk-ins in the preceding quarter. Further, we are seeing some revival in housing projects which were stuck for almost 6 months. Many builders are now seeing sale of inventory. New projects are being taken up, particularly in the budget and affordable housing sector. We are also seeing a clear shift in the consumer ecosystem. Consumers are now making their living space a better one as they understand they will spend more time at home than outside, even when the situation normalizes. More and more consumers are taking home upgrades. Shankara Building Products continued its effort in cost optimization and cost control. This has yielded in positive results. As this is a continuous operation, we hope to see the full benefit in the coming year. The company's focus on balance sheet continues, and we should see further positive results in the year ending 31st March 2021. Our relationship with key suppliers continues to be cordial, and we have further cemented our bonds due to increased lifting with them coupled with better payment terms. Let me take you through the financial highlights for the quarter. Revenues. Quarter 3 FY21 revenue stood at Rs. 560 crores, a growth of 15% quarter-on-quarter basis, and the corresponding figure for Q3 FY20 was Rs. 700 crores. For the financial year, we are in line with our revised budget target. For 9 months FY21, revenue from retail contributed 58%, channel revenue was 22%, and enterprise revenue was at 20% to the total sales. We are observing an uptick in demand in general from the Tier 2 Tier 3 cities. Further, even the Tier 1 demand is picking up. EBITDA. On the EBITDA side, there was a turnaround in business operation from operating loss of Rs. 9 crores in FY21 to an operating profit of Rs. 20 crores in Q2 FY21, and further, an operating profit of Rs. 38 crores in Q3 FY21. This has resulted in an overall EBITDA of Rs. 49 crores for the 9 month period for the current year. Absolute EBITDA for Q3 FY21 stood at Rs. 38 crores. EBITDA margin for the quarter was at 6.8% versus 4.1% in Q2 FY21 and 4.7% in Q3 FY20, an increase of 270 bits on quarter-on-quarter basis and 209 bits on year-on-year basis. PAT. Q3 FY21, PAT stood at Rs. 22 crores versus 12 crores in Q3 FY20, reflecting a 89% growth. Q1 has a net loss of 25 crores, Q2 PAT of 6 crores, and Q3 PAT of 22 crores stand at 28 crores. This has resulted in a PAT for the 9 month period at Rs. 3 crores. In these challenging times, for the 9 months ending 31st December 2020, The company has been able to reduce its debtors by rupees 148 crores and inventory by rupees 56 crores versus March 2020. In Q3, there was a significant reduction in net working capital days to 62 days as compared to 76 days in Q2 FY21. This number is comparable to Q4 FY20, which stood at 63 days. And the operating cash flow for the 9 months FY21 stood at 101 crores. Now let us focus on segmental performance of the company. Retail segment. Retail sales for 9 months FY21 stood at rupees 816 crores as compared to 1077 crores in 9 months FY20. On a sequential basis, sales stood at rupees 323 crores in Q3 FY21 as compared to 283 crores in Q2 FY21, a growth of 14%. The segment profit stood at 8.05% for the quarter. We have taken a continuous call over a year and a half to rationalize our retail operations. Consequently, we have shut down over 30 stores. Currently, we have 97 stores under the brand Shankara Build Pro. We believe that we can achieve our future target with less number of stores more effectively. This means that the throughput of each store would increase substantially. Further, our supply chain will be more cost efficient and effective. Average rental cost for leased outlets stood at rupees 16.65 per square feet per month for Q3 FY21 as compared to rupees 20.59 for Q3 FY20. The total area of the stores comes at around 471,000 square feet with an average store size of 4,666 square feet. Average ticket size per transaction was approximately 34,942 for Q3 FY21, up from 28,676 in Q3 FY20. Channel and enterprise sales. Channel and enterprise in 9 months FY21 stood at rupees 580 crores. It contributed 42% of the consolidated revenue of the company. In Q3 FY21, the revenue stood at 238 crores as against Q2 FY21 of rupees 205 crores, a 16% growth quarter on quarter basis. The sale in the enterprise segment has started rebounding and now contributes 53% of this segment as compared to 48% in Q2 FY21. The segment profit stood at 6.4% for the quarter. However, I wish to add that this segment gained substantially due to favorable commodity prices. On processing, our processing units are slowly ramping up to meet our requirements as per the current market condition. We have changed our operation substantially to cater to an optimal production based on the requirements as per the current market scenario. On this basis, we are currently operating at 70% of capacity and the units are profitable. So the conclusion, the recent union budget has focused on boosting infrastructure spend. We hope that this will augur well for Shankara Building Products, as all our products, particularly steel and pipes and tubes, go into infrastructure in a big way. Shankara Building is a lean organization focused on our retail operation and to be a leading retailer in building materials. However, given the experience of the pandemic, which is a black swan event, we feel that our channel and enterprise business has held us good stead in these difficult times. In the retail business, we wish to grow rapidly on the non-steel segment, which is relatively new to the organization. Further, we are also aware of our limitation to expand very rapidly, which requires a huge infusion of funds. Therefore, we will grow with internal funds generated from our operations. We are confident that this will lead to a healthy growth in volumes as well as profitability. With this, I open the floor to the floor discussion. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. The first question is from the line of Siddharth Rajpurohit from JHP Securities. Please go ahead.
Good morning, everyone, and congratulations on a steady recovery and very strong margins, sir. So I would like to understand what would be the absolute term inventory gain in the quarter, sir, as indicated by sir?
It's approximately around 10 crores.
And this the spread between retail and channel, sir?
Maximum will be in the channel and enterprise. Retail will be less.
Okay. And sir, what will be our same store sales growth, sir?
Same store sales growth on a yearly basis, the number will be negative, but on a sequential basis, there is a growth.
Okay. Okay, but year on year, we are still down, sir?
Actually, I think the sales SSG will really be more relevant at the end of this quarter, because some of the numbers still may not be really comparable compared to last year. So I think we'll have a more meaningful number that will come out in Q4.
Yeah, because I want to understand, sir, what is hindering our growth? Because if I see the OEMs, the tile manufacturers or the pipe manufacturers or the paint manufacturers, everybody is showing strong year-on-year volume growth.
Yeah.
So what is the reason, sir, that we are still at 80% or 82% of the pre-pandemic time, sir?
Yeah, I think this is a call we took right in the beginning of the year that we are going to remain at the 75 to 80% of our top line compared to the last year. I know that a lot of people have recovered substantially in quarter three and so on. But in our case, because we are much, much smaller, we are not a manufacturing unit. We are largely in the retail sector. So the real walk-ins and the real growth has only started in Q3. See, the first two quarters, we still were quite stuck. So I think better answer to your question would really come in Q4.
Okay, so Q4, we see a strong demand recovery, sir?
We hope so. I mean, they are still in the early stages. 1 month is over. So we hope that it will happen in this quarter.
But January, we have reached at about 100% utilization, 100% of pre-COVID, sir?
Sorry?
In January, we have reached 90%+.
We are at about 85-86%. So there is sequential growth.
Okay.
So we hope that we will see the maybe reaching on parity by March.
Okay. So is our credit policy some hindrance, sir?
Come again? Credit?
Is the credit policy that we are following? We move to a tighter credit to our clients, sir. So,
credits to our clients, sir.
Okay. So, means is that one reason for the relatively slower growth as compared to the industry, sir?
No, one is as per the we had an internal budget. We are following that budget for the year.
Okay.
So, basically, on that, we are tightening the credit and we are going as per our budgets to achieve the annual targets.
Okay. And the store closure that we have taken, sir, is it now come to an end, sir?
Almost we are to an end. More or less, maybe a couple of stores. Otherwise, we should be around this many number of stores.
Okay. And, sir, what would be your guidance for the retail segment and channel segment margins going forward, sir?
Retail would be 6-8%, and channel would be around 3-4% in the normal market conditions.
Okay. But given the current scenario where even at 80%, we have reached 8%, so is it possible that we can go further higher?
No, may not be, but we are planning to, or because the more we expect margins, no, we may lose out the opportunity. We are planning to be around 6-8%.
Thank you, sir. All the best. I have more questions. I'll come back in the queue.
Thank you.
Thank you. A reminder to the participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one now. The next question is from the line of Amish Kanani from JM Financial Services. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Congrats on a relative improvement QOQ. So my question is, how are we seeing the footfalls? I understand that our business is not so much driven by footfall, but on the retail side, how are we seeing the footfalls in terms of, inquiry? And in general, we have seen that footfalls are down, but, revenue per customer is up. So, if you can give us some sense of how the trend is, and in key, tier two cities where, we are present, whether the COVID after effects are still, feeling, or say after Diwali, we have seen a lot of improvement and on the footfall side. So you can give us a typical
Footfall has been mentioned in our opening speech. From now, it has relatively improved to around 10 per counter, as against 5, which was in the previous quarter.
Can you repeat? I mean,
around 5 per day.
5 per day.
Previous quarter, like quarter 2, it was around 5. Now, quarter 3, it has improved to around 10 per day average.
Okay.
There is a improvement.
And how is this, say, how would you compare this vis-a-vis say, pre-pandemic and in terms of percentage? Because what I understand is, though footfall is low, the conversion is high. Yeah. Only serious customers come. So that's where.
Conversion is absolutely.
Yeah.
Almost 70% of the walk-ins we are converting to them.
About 70%. And sir, other question is, how was the behavior of the customer is in terms of, in this type of product, generally it's very difficult to, purchase e-commerce, e-commerce conversion. So how is the consumer behavior here in our segment? Is it possible that more and more people could, still choose the product e-commerce or you think our line of business, it is, important for them to come, to our store? And what are we doing to kind of capture this trend, if any, sir? Thanks.
Presently, the customers, like whatever existing customers we have, they are quite comfortable. And as far as e-commerce, still people are not very much, as you said, very difficult for them to choose a product or
However, we also have a site, as we have always mentioned, which also captures the sale or whatever it comes in through the portal. So largely what we find is that the portal is used more as a catalog. And I think then there's always a helpline number, which is where we find that the ultimate sale is closed. So this is the current trend. We have seen the same trend over the last 2 years, 2.5 years, ever since we've had the portal. So we expect the same to continue, but we are geared up from e-commerce angle that if the sale does dramatically go up there, we are ready to capture the sale.
Okay. And sir, in terms of sales, if you can give us some flavor of, we have seen a lot of sales improvement as far as the, built home is concerned, So in terms of cycles, sir, the way our products are being sold, if you can give us some sense of, whether our products, do they immediately get bought, say, after the 3 months of fresh homes being built, or it is we are more in the cycle of, a refreshment and, refurbishment, whenever they do, we generally have those kind of, sales. So if you can give us some flavor, whether our sales is how closely it is linked to the new property sale versus, a normal, refurbishment of the house. And what are the trends there? Given that we have, as what our previous participant asked, a lot of building material companies have shown a strong growth, maybe due to some pent-up demand. But if you can give us some sense of how are we linked to the real estate cycle. Thanks.
Yeah. So I think there are three kinds of sales that really we look at. One is new homes, which start from scratch. So generally the pattern of sale is there is we have scouts from every counter who are on the field. So we try and tap in, at whatever is starting under construction. So normally if we are successful in meeting the term, it starts with steel. So, and followed by cement. And then it probably our range of supply continues over a year till that house or the building is completed. So this is one pattern. Second is we also cater to smaller builders, etc., where it's a slightly more bulk orders where the similar project comes in, maybe some of the tap ads when they are nearing completion or middle level of completion where certain plumbing items go in, some of the concealed faucets, etc., go in. And so generally the sale for any of these areas is spread over a period of time. It does not happen people walk in and they just freeze things and go. They may freeze, but the supply is always spread. So one of the key things that we also target is to see what is in our pipeline all the time. So one of the key things that we have learned over this last few years is your pipeline is to always be strong in order to continuously have a generation of business. So these are the two areas where you need a pipeline generation. The third is what you said about the upgrades and people who are, let's say, they're redoing a toilet or they're doing a bathroom or they're redoing their floors or something like that. That also is always spread over a month or two, unless it's a spot purchase of one tap or one specific item that is available in the store. So we have, it's a mix of all the three. Our focus is more and more towards one and two because that is what really keeps the pipeline going and that's what gives you the kind of comfort in the sales as you look forward.
Sure. And sir, last question from my side with your permission you hinted that we will settle for slightly lower margin gear up for the growth. So the question is, sir, is it that our product is slightly less competitive vis-a-vis competition and hence we are planning to become more competitive, or that in certain products, we want to enter which are less margin, but we want more growth and hence, that kind of slightly lower margin, but higher growth kind of, a number that we're speaking about?
I would say it's a mix of both. There are many products where we are very competitive in the market. There are also some areas which we would like to focus where we can take a look at higher volumes, where we need to be probably a little more competitive. So it's a mix of both. So that is what I think my colleague indicated when we were talking about the 6-8% margin level only.
Okay. Yeah, thanks a lot, sir. And all the best.
Thank you. We would request the participants to please limit your questions to 2 per participant. The next question is from the line of Deepak Poddar from Spark Capital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you very much for the opportunity. Sir, I just missed the number you mentioned. Inventory gain was how much?
Hello? Yeah, I think just lost you.
I just missed the number. Inventory gain that you mentioned was how much in rupees crores?
10 crores.
10 crores was the inventory gain in this quarter. Okay. Fair enough. So my query is related to your, you mentioned about Jan 21, we are at about 85-86% of pre-COVID utilization and we expect to reach parity by March. So by parity, you mean what, the 225 to 50 crores per month revenue that we used to do? So is that what we are looking at?
We are certainly targeting that, but I would rather put the number around 200 to 220 in the March.
200 to 220, fair enough.
Yeah.
And the point that you mentioned about that we are basically fine to settle for a lower margin to drive growth. So what sort of growth are we looking at if you have to look at FY22?
We said we will balance the margin.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but we are looking at a growth of anywhere between 20-25%.
20-25% from the base that we have currently.
Yes.
Fair enough. Okay, that's it from my side. Thank you very much.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Maulik Patel from Equirus Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thanks for the opportunity. Few questions. Our net debt plus acceptance at the end of March was around 345 crore. And since last three quarters, June, September and October, we are at around 290 CR. And in the presentation, it has mentioned that our operating cash flow has been in the range of around 100 CR plus for the first 9 months. So has our working capital has gone up? How do I adjust this mess? Because since last three quarters, our debt plus acceptance is now declining.
So I think the math is because some of the we had also to see in the first two quarters the creditors also had come down substantially.
Okay. What is our payable as of now, as of December?
Overall, in December, the creditors has marginally gone up. What was around 30 crores in the third quarter has gone up to around 75-80 crores in the in the second quarter. It was about 30 odd crores of the creditors, that is the trade creditors, which has gone up to around 70-75 in the third quarter.
Okay. So what is our working capital as of December 20? Because I think receivable we have is around 281 CR, inventory is around 344. I understand because of the steel prices has gone up, so there is an increase in both receivable and inventory.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Samalik, I think we didn't get your question. What is the...
What is the working capital, net working capital as of December 20?
It is 290 crores.
Including
acceptance was supposed to be around 130 crores.
Sorry, can you repeat, Alex? Can you repeat it?
290 crores is the total working capital, including an acceptance of 130 crores.
Okay, fine, great. Second question is that, Sukumar, you always mentioned that the focus for this year has been on the balance sheet, and it's been since largely achieved. And now, given that the push in the commodity prices and you desire to have gone back to the earlier level, as the revenue growth for which you say that around 20-25% for next year, will there be a corresponding increase in working capital?
No.
And how do we want to achieve that? Because since I think since 1 year or probably a little more than that, we started focusing on the channel part of the business, which we earlier defocused in year of FY18-19, there was a defocus on that. But since last year, there is a focus on the channel part of the business. And I understand that channel is a little more working capital intensive business compared to the other two vertical what we have.
Yeah, so one of the key things that we have focused, if you see the current year's reduction in both inventory and receivables, this will continue to go on. Okay. Lastly, we also mentioned in the opening speech that we are fueling our growth only through internal accruals and so on.
Sure.
So I think you should watch the space as on March this year to see where our working capital actually end at. So I think that will probably illustrate where we are driving at further.
Okay. And just last question, there was a pretty sharp number of stores which we closed in this quarter was almost around 19 stores. And can I know the reason, what led to this store closures, and how do you select this store is going to be? Is it more about profitability at a store level? That was the metrics, or you had some of the, let's say in Bangalore, you have around 19 stores, or probably more than that, and you wanted to reduce the number of stores, and so what was the thought process behind that?
I think the thought process started pre-COVID also. So I think basically, and probably it accelerated in the post lockdowns and so on. So I think profitability was the driving, A. B, what was the growth that we have registered in some of those stores over the last 3 years or 4 years after they were opened. So I think these were the two parameters on what we really looked at. Thirdly, we also looked at, let us say a store in the vicinity there is another store. We could see that what is the catchment that the existing better performing store was able to do. And so what we've also seen after some of the initial closure of stores, we found that a neighboring store, which may be 5-6 kilometers away, was fairly able to capture the business that may have been lost in the closed store. So I think that is why when somebody asked me the question earlier about SSG, I would really like you to watch that space probably in quarter one next year,
where I think there will be a fairly substantial SSG growth in our rationalization process. So I think this has been the thought that has really gone behind closure of stores. And it's not that we have closed these stores, we are not going to open anything further. But I think we will take a rational thought about what we are going to do in the coming year.
Thank you. We take the last question from Siddharth Rajpurohit from JHP Securities. Please go ahead.
Thank you for the opportunity again, sir. Sir, first, on the management fees, sir, if we see it is still down around 50% from where it was pre-pandemic. So how do you see this and when it will be coming back, sir?
Can you repeat the question? We didn't get it.
So we report the EBITDA number, right, sir, in the segment performance?
Yeah.
So if we remove the depreciation from the unallocable cost, we will get the console corporate cost, right, sir? So that cost was around 6-7 crores earlier, which is now coming down to only 2.5 to 3 crores. So I wanted to know how much of this cost will come back, sir?
Very little of it will come back.
Okay. And, sir, how are the stores that we acquired a few years back performing now, sir? And have we closed any of those stores, sir?
Yeah. No, we have probably one of the three stores in Chennai we have closed of what we acquired. Otherwise, I think they're all doing reasonably well, and the Bangalore 3 stores are doing pretty good.
Okay. And sir, what will be our gross debt and cash level, sir?
Gross debt and cash level.
Gross debt is 290 crores as on end of December.
Yeah.
Which includes acceptance of 126 crores.
126 crore acceptance.
136 crores acceptance. Which includes in this 290.
And cash, sir?
Cash is around 4 to 5 crores.
4 to 5 crores. Okay, sir. Yeah, and sorry, what
is like, after reducing the cash, I'm saying. So we are on 296 minus cash of 5 crores, it is coming 290.
Okay, cash of 5 crores. Okay, sir.
Yeah.
What are about CapEx plans, sir?
CapEx, we don't have any substantial plans other than augmenting our warehousing only. So it will be a nominal number next year.
Okay. And how do you see, sir, going forward, what will be, say, 3-4 years down the line, the share of non-steel products in the overall sales?
Share of steel products. Share of steel will probably in about 4 years, what we anticipate is it should come down to about, currently, if you look at the retail segment, we are at about pure non-steel is about 15%, and including some partial glazing products, etc., we are at non-steel is about 25%. So we broadly, in the entire business, we would like to bring the share of steel down to around 60%. That's the target in the next 4 years.
Okay. Thank you, sir, and all the best, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. That was the last question. I now end the conference. Over to Mr. Alex Vergis for closing comments.
Thank you everyone for joining us. I hope we have able to answer all your queries. In case you require any further details, you may please contact us or our investor relations advisors, strategic growth advisors. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. On behalf of Shankara Building Products Limited, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.